This is the first play of its type ever written by an Australian with a Vietnamese background in Australia about the Vietnamese people here.
Okay, is it a, what sort of a play is it? Is it one of hope? Is it one of, with a lot of problems involved? What sort of tack do you take?
When I set out to write this play, it was more for the Vietnamese people. It's for them to look at themselves. More than writing a play about, you know, Vietnamese for non-Vietnamese people, you know, it's for, that's why it's more important. It's a play for Vietnamese people, but at the same time, I'm giving the non-Vietnamese people a chance to see what's the world like within the Vietnamese community
in Australia.
In Australia, and what are our problems and our difficulties?
You told me just before coming on air that there are 26 cast members. Now that's that's a big cast. How many important roles are there? How many major roles?
There are seven main roles in the play. Six of the main characters are Vietnamese and one non-Vietnamese, and the rest are non-Vietnamese people.
When did you come to Australia yourself?
I came to Australia in 1978.
Now, how difficult was it for you? You would have come as a child. All of a sudden coming across a community, the likes of which I guess you hadn't lived in before. And back in 1978, I think that the community that was already here, they were feeling their way with the Vietnamese who were joining us, because it wasn't all that long after the war in Vietnam. So I suppose it's fair, I don't want to say sides, but I can't think of anything else. I suppose it was difficult for both sides, as it were.
Yeah, I think the Vietnamese people came to Australia at a time where a lot of the Australian people aren't really prepared yet. I mean, we're talking about the White Australia policy was still in place by the time that we got here, and it's secretly died out. But a lot of people didn't expect there were so many Vietnamese going to come to Australia to live, and that and we're going to be here forever, and it's not like we're going to be here just temporarily. I think that was a shock for the Australians here, but at the same time there was a shock for the Vietnamese people that they didn't realise that they're going to be here forever as well.
What were the problems you encountered?
I think the biggest problem that I'm trying to address in my play is this generation gaps between the young people and the old and the old people. You know, they come to Australia with their own set of values and customs and traditions, and where the young people who have grown up here in this country have learned everything different. So that's why there is that tension. And then both sides trying to change each other. The young people trying to change the parents and saying, well, you must try to change and live my way. And at the same time, the parents trying to do the other thing. The parents want the young kids to try to live their way back in Vietnam.
Yeah.
But I think it's just impossible.
It's always been thus, of course, with migration. History shows us that. And in relatively recent times in Australia, I'm bold enough to remember when Arthur Cornwell put in to place the immigration program after the Second World War. And the predominance of migrants coming to Australia were English, British, but also Italians. And basically, for the first time in the sort of numbers that they arrived in the late 40s, early 50s, and there was a problem there, primarily with the older Italian people who just didn't understand that their young people were taking on some of the customs of Australia, some of the attitudes of Australia, because it. They were leading two lives, the life at school, the life on the streets, and then the life at home, and that's the difficulty, isn't it?
I think that's where the heartbeat is. The hard one are the one that in between, like my generations, where I'm the one who came to Australia at a young age, so I was born in Vietnam, so I still am very much influenced.
How old were you in 78?
10.
Yeah, well, formative years.
And then now we've got another generation of Vietnamese who are born here, and they're more Australians. I mean, I feel that I'm more Australian than Vietnamese at the moment, because I've lived here for the past 17 years now. I've lived in Vietnam nine years.
Did you get a hard time at school?
Yeah, when I went to school here, it was very hard. It was very, very tough. We were brought up in Broadmeadows. We were one of the first Vietnamese family living out there, and kids are very cruel, you know. They're not like adults. They don't think logically. And
physical attacks?
Occasionally, yeah.
Just because you were Vietnamese?
Because I'm Vietnamese. Yeah.
Name-calling, obviously.
Name-callings and you know, the jingles and the advertising, the commercials on TV, all those little jingles about little products, food or anything that relate to Asian. And if there's a jingle, they use that to come to school to tease you.
Mm. How did you cope with that?
Very hard. I think that's one thing that my parents don't realise how hard it is for us, because I have a big family. I've got 7 brothers and sisters. My parents could never understand why that sort of thing affect your school, you know, and they couldn't really understand how could that really affect your relationship with people and how that's going to affect your whole life.
Is the answer legislation, or is the answer education, or is the answer time?
I think it's a bit a combination of all three. I don't think there is a magical solution. I think information is very important. Education is also important. Mm. But to a certain extent, legislation, you know, if people were making threats to, physical and threat to other people because of their skin colour, I think that we have to do something about it.
Yeah. Well, that's got to be through education, hasn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. I mean, but at the same time, my play, it's not talking about all the negative stuff. I mean,
shows hope.
It's very sad, but also at the same time it's hype. But I'm trying to show, you know, all the warning signs, all the danger there, that my family's been through all this and how I actually come to a resolution. And the resolution is that we've got to come to a stage where we have to learn to agree to disagree, and that none of us should try to change the other one totally. We have to go to a place where we just say, okay, well, I'll disagree with you. And disagreement's okay. I mean, it's like anything in life, that even between yourself and your wife or with your kids, they might like to watch a different movie, they might have different taste in music to you, they might have different taste in clothing.
You must have been to that place last night, were you? Yeah. Yeah, I know what you mean. It's all about tolerance, isn't it? And and also understanding and I suppose belief that we can live together.
I think so.
So you open on Thursday of this week in Footscray. Whereabouts in Footscray?
Footscray Community Arts Centre. This is in Moreland Street, Footscray.
Good luck with that. And the season goes through till when?
It opens on the 21st, 22nd, 23rd.
Yeah.
The first week is almost sold out.
Yep.
And then the 28th, 29th and 30th.
Good luck with it.
Can I give my number?
Certainly.
Yeah, the telephone number for the Footscray Community Arts Centre is 9689-5677.
Might be good for some advertorials. I mean, that was done beautifully. But you've got to do special offers too, you know. Not only that, but also this. Good to see you, Tony, and good luck for Thursday and for the entire season.
Okay.
Please thank Tony Le-Nguyen. The play is called Che Vong Vong, which is running in circles,
running
isn't
in circles,
it?
Yeah. Yep.
I hope it goes well for you.